And psychopaths have a very similar life cycle to parasites. A lot of similarities there. I'm working on another video that would link and show how the parasitic strategy of survival is the one that tends to be adopted by psychopaths. But socially, that's a different question. And a lot of people said, well, you know, we can't do this. We can't. What we should do is we should have a test and test all politicians to see whether they're psychopaths. And then if they are, imprison them. Or a lot of people advocate shooting them and other forms of violence. And I think this would be an absolute disaster. I do not think any sort of test or screening process would either work or be necessary. Well, it wouldn't work. Any kind of screening process, some sort of test that you come up with to prove whether or not somebody's a psychopath, would quickly be subverted by the psychopaths in power right now. They've subverted every law we've established and every democratic system or republican system or system of government rules and procedures and morality and codes of conduct. They've subverted all those in the past 4,000 years. None of those things have worked on them. I seriously doubt that any kind of test is going to work on them. They'll quickly take it over. They'll bribe, blackmail, or eliminate whoever's in charge of those tests, and the test will be reversed, and soon it'll be anybody that has a conscience should be executed. So what to do with society, how to change it around? You know, we're always talking about, and especially in the truth movement and in the activist movement, and everybody's always talking about waking people up, waking people up. And I got to be really sick of that. Well, okay, let's wake everybody up, and then what happens? But unfortunately, I'm back to the waking people up approach. I don't think we can sort of find any search and destroy method of getting rid of psychopaths. But the psychopaths derive their power from the complicity of the general population. It's only because most people still get suckered in by the manipulation, and most people still admire them. So if somehow, and I'm hoping the video and the book, and there's also a booklet you can download, and people spreading the word about what psychopaths are, if the better informed they are, the better able they're able they are to spot them, and then start to socially distance them. It's the same sort of strategy that you would use if there was a pandemic. You have to socially distance yourself from the infection and infected people. And I think society as a whole, if we can socially distance ourselves from the psychopaths, and we don't need a test, we don't need anybody to tell us. If you recognize the patterns and the symptoms, even whether your diagnosis is wrong or not, your behavior is not going to harm them simply by cutting them off of food, meaning your money, your attention, your devotion. So you're not hurting them by cutting them off. You're depriving them of what they want. You're depriving, you're depriving a junkie of heroin. But you can't say by removing heroin from a junkie, you're actually doing violence against the junkie. So the same thing with society. If we can sort of isolate these people and then remove their access to the power, then we can cut them off. And we're not doing violence to them, yet they won't be able to have the power and control to create so much destruction and evil. And there's no other word for it. It's evil what's going on in the world. So I'm back down to waking people up. Yeah.
For more on this story and other breaking news and current events, please go to globalresearch.ca. For more research and analysis by James Corbett, please go to corbettreport.com.